He can change the prostitute. And he did in the Bible. He can change the drug addict. Is there anybody here out of their mind? Anybody here out of your mind? All right. Come down here. I want to show these people a miracle. Come here. Come on down. All right. Are you out of your mind? All right. Turn around and look at the people. This man is totally out of his mind. You can go to your chair now. Now, people, let me tell you something. This guy right here is out of his mind as he is.
Is there a doctor in the audience?
Yes, there is. Christ came for this man right here. He's not out of his mind. If he was, he wouldn't admit.
Rather than thought of your next comment, you would have heard me say we are polluting our earth. And it's a global problem. And it concerns you whether you are white, black, brown, yellow, Christian, Hindu, Muslim, Taoist, it doesn't matter. Our world is being polluted. Our world is heating up. Our world will flood. The British government have a policy for it. The American government have a policy for it. The Ghanaian government have a policy for it. None of these policies dovetail. None of these policies make any sense. The Polish government can be as environmentally friendly as it wants. If another Chernobyl reactor, like the one in Ukraine, explodes, pollution will come across Poland.
Might come to Britain.
It may well come to Britain. In Europe, we are tidying up our environmental act. In America and Canada and Australia, they are not. In India and China, they are stepping up their use of coal. It's a global problem. And we will never, ever, ever address the issues of our sustainable earth. We will never protect our global commons for the future generations of our planet until we have a global consensus. And we will never have a global consensus until we have global law and global order. And I say to all of you here today, it's a simple thing. Wherever you're from, whatever language you speak, whatever faith you practice, a synagogue, a temple, a church. You are a member of a world community.
Not Cuba.
You are a world.
Not Cuba. Cuba's nothing wrong.
Well, you say Cuba's not involved. We say to you this. You are members of a world community. You are world citizens. You have rights as world citizens. You have responsibilities as world citizens. We urge you, educate yourselves and inform yourselves what happens in your world, what happens to your environment, what happens to your fellow human beings around the world, and use your freedom. If you are from a country where you have the freedom of a democratic exercise, use that.
What is democracy?
Right to your
what
life.
What is democracy? There is no democracy.
There will never be any democracy.
What is democracy? All the people, by the people.
Yes, sir.
And the people have got no